Hello and welcome back to the Homeless World Keepy Uppy Cup. It's day 5 of the competition and the turn of Group E. But first, a quick reminder of the rules. Each country has nominated a player to represent them, and their simple challenge is to score as many points as possible in 30 seconds. Players will score 3 points for each use of the shoulder, 2 points for the head, and 1 point for anything below the waist, so knees, thighs, or feet. Any drops are use of the hands, and it's a 2-point deduction. We start with the men's competition, 8 groups and 33 teams vying for a place in the last 16, where teams must nominate a new player to represent them. Only the top 2 from each group will qualify. And this is Group E. It features Argentina, Japan, Paraguay and the US of A. Unfortunately, Paraguay weren't able to get their entry in for this one, but let's learn more about the rest of the group. Argentina last participated in 2015, where they came 20th. They have been attending the Homeless World Cup since 2005. The team is managed by Hecho Club Social. Japan's most recent participation took place in 2011. Their very first appearance was in 2004. The team is managed by Big Issue Japan and the team name is Nobushi, the Wandering Warriors. And Team USA reached the 22nd place at last year's Homeless World Cup in Cardiff. They first attended the Homeless World Cup back in 2003 and the USA squad is managed by Street Soccer USA. So first up we have Argentina. Great foot control there, and straight away you can sense the confidence because he's doing this in quite a small room to say the least. Very confident of his ball control, and we can see why in the first 13 seconds. He's so controlled there. Down onto the thighs. Can he get up to the shoulder or the head? There he can. Yes, he can. Very confident. That space he's got there is very small, and that ball is glued to him. Fantastic stuff by Argentina. He's like Lionel Messi, and the clock is up. And let's have a look at the final score then. A few headers in there, lots below the waist. 96, what a great marker. And they go to the top, and that'll be tough to beat. Here goes Japan. Look at this ball, absolutely glued to his feet. It's hardly bouncing or moving off his foot. The repetitive nature of the 1 point here is absolutely massive by Japan, but will it be enough to beat Argentina? That's the big question. It's really tough to count, to be honest with you. Not long left now on the clock. And this is absolutely great stuff. A superb display by Japan. Great control on that right foot. But how many ones were there? Oh, it's a massive score. 103. And Japan moved to the top of the group. What can USA offer then? Oh my word, very similar to Japan. But this time on the left foot. Look at that ball. It is hardly moving off that left foot of his. But the ones are racking up very, very quick here for USA. This is going to be extremely close. There's no doubt about that at all. And he's still going with that left foot. No ambition to go higher. And why not with the pace of these one-pointers? And he just about keeps it going there. Nearly stopped dead, didn't it, the ball? And the clock has stopped. What's the damage then? Let's have a look. 107! Oh my word! USA go to the top of the group. The standard here is extremely high. And because Paraguay couldn't get their video to us, this is the final standings. USA 107, Japan 103. Commiserations to Argentina, who did so well, and also to Paraguay. Take your seat and support your team in our virtual stadium at homelessworldcup.org and share your favourite episodes on social media using the hashtag #KeepTheBallRolling. Finals will take place on July the 5th as part of the Homeless World Cup Day. Thanks for joining us. See you all next time for Group F, featuring England, Northern Ireland, Togo and Wales. Bye for now.